How to be evil.
Hey guys, Jack here. Welcome to chapter 4 of How to Be Evil. Yes, the evil genius goodness. We cannot wait. Now, firstly, apology to those who may have followed the previous link. Started already. The previous link that I gave you for the unofficial patch, that unfortunately didn't work. I did put a post up on how to get the new unofficial patch. Hopefully you guys saw that video. Now, the only thing is that there is a little bit of a problem sometimes when you do the patch. If you've got a game ongoing, essentially what happens is that it stalls the game for random reasons and you can't progress any further. I found that with my Evil Genius Chapter 3 save game. And so essentially what you're seeing here is an entirely new base that I built this morning. So basically trying to replicate everything from the episode. So there are some minor differences. As you can see here, I just made the armory a little smaller and the freezer a little bigger so I can get more rats in there and more bodies and all the rest of it. We'll need it later. And obviously, you know, now that the patch is in there, I get nice soft chairs. The infirmary doesn't go all the way around there. And that's about it, really. So I was thinking that as I kind of, you know, could have screwed up your save game and annoyed a lot of people, let's just assassinate him, that I should give you some compensation for that. So I think it's only fair that I actually make this episode an extra half hour longer. So this will be a 1 hour and 30 minute episode, or chapter, I should say, of How to Be Evil. So, guys, settle down and enjoy yourself. I know I will. Now, let's see what we're doing. So, we're looking, there's the Evil Genius thing all set up. That's going to be another room which you'll see later. That's where my research area is going to be. And as you can see, blah, 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 all there. Training like madmen we are. And as you can see, I've got 40 guards. I want as many guards as I can get. 106 capacity. That's thanks to the patch. And reasonable amount of technicians and valets. So they're in there, doing their funky thing. As you can see, plenty of guards. As soon as they basically, like this guy here, for example, what he's going to do is as soon as he is trained, which he is now trained, he's going to make his way over to the armory and arm up. Now, I think what I'm going to do then is stick an armory very quickly here so that it's, literally they don't have to go that far to get tooled up, so to speak. So let's just have a look. Let's put one in there. And we'll put a rifle, and a handgun, and then we'll put a one for later characters in there as well. So that means this guy doesn't have to walk all the way up here to get his bullets. So, as you can see, the Uber trap is up and running. All looking good there with that respect. It hasn't been destroyed yet. My personal game that I was playing yesterday, just to try things out, basically this got destroyed and rebuilt about 4 times thanks to soldiers. The trouble with soldiers when you are playing this game is that soldiers come in basically and they just destroy everything. They shoot at all this thing, and if they can see, they shoot out and they end up, this all catches fire, everything catches fire, and you end up having to rebuild it. Fortunately, I've got a reasonable amount of cash in the bank and I don't have to worry about that. So there's the gold room there. Now what I did is I had, because these were level 4 doors, you had guys standing on this side on the inside, which was okay, but I wanted them on the outside primarily. So what I did was I put this here, the rack, right in front there, took the door out, put that rack right in front so that basically nobody can get into that room unless I open one of these doors. Now it could be that I get burglars who sneak in, come in through a trapdoor. All I've got to do, right click, open one of those rooms, send the Jubai in, and he can chop them into fish bait. So as you can see, I've set up another shortcut. So control 1 for that shortcut. And then I set up this other shortcut with control 2. So I just press 1 and 2. And it takes me to either side of the base. Very quick to navigate around. Now, let's have a look to see what's going on the world stage. Now, what I did was I sent out some plotters. Now, the thing is, this is hard. None of these things will show up unless you go out there and plot for it. Now, obviously, on the easier levels... Yes, yes, shut up. On the easier levels, basically stuff will just turn up just by having people there. So it's a lot easier in that respect. But on this game, you have to plot for it on the hard mode. So we're going to send out... What I like to do is always send out one more than you actually need, because sometimes when you do it, it causes a problem and all of a sudden these people turn up. Now, the thing is, if you look at the timing, that's 3 minutes. That's 3 minutes. And that's 3 minutes. Now, sometimes what will happen is that will complete first, and then that one basically will get a guard in there, and he'll end up causing that mission to fail. So, let's see. We've got how many guards in there? Five guards. So we'll put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, just to be on the safe side. We've got to put some technicians in there later. We are going to be putting... let's have a look. Yep, six of those guys in there. That'll be fine. We don't want to get that yet. We'll get that later on. We'll put some guards and valets after we've got these guys. And obviously that'll be the technicians, and we'll do some other missions and get some notoriety. So, all we got to do is wait for those guys to get helicoptered in. Check to make sure our Uber trap has not been destroyed by interlopers and foot padders. Right, so there's a burglar. And now the thing is, what you can do is you can turn that to one, and it will lose interest in it because that's not the ultra-locked secret door. Now, if this guy sets this one off, which hopefully he will, come on, set it off, set it off. What you can do is you can essentially fudge it and make it level one, and then this guy will think, oh, what's this? Oh, nothing interesting, and he'll walk his way back in through here, and they basically walk straight into the trap, and then you can set it to level three behind them, and it locks them straight in. So, you know, here we go. So this guy's on his way back. This is essentially kind of using the AI. These agents aren't particularly smart. He's a poor sable of burglar. So he can just go out. There we go. Level three, he's locked in. So he's got to break his way out. Level three, so that the basically my own minions don't wander into here by mistake, because they've got these little sensors. So that when they walk across this area, basically they set up the traps off. Now also, one thing that's quite handy is to put tourists in there. You have to set these doors to level one. They sneak in there. As soon as you lock the doors, they start going wild and panicky and hitting the microphone. And they have a tendency to set these traps off all the time. So it's a good way of ensuring that this trap is operating often. So very helpful in that respect. So as you can see, strong room's all good there. That's looking fine. Got to keep an eye on that in case we hear any kind of burglaries going on. Now what I've done here is... not much different really. What I did was I pushed that wall back a little bit, put a little bit of extra space in there, put those two back to back. That thing there basically covers these guys learning here. This guy covers these guys learning here. Additional bits and pieces in there so that I've got a nice collection of men available to me. So let's see. Nope, helicopter. See, nope, not out there yet. So as you can see, can't do that mission as of yet. So it will also generate us some heat. Now, if we look at our objectives, so you've got this basically, we've got the Inner Sanctum, which we've built, and we've got the Indian subcontinent, Armand Krishnan, and then Marvin DeLuca and the inscrutable Li Ying Lo. So, those are the main guys we've got to get. Now, the thing is, there's probably going to be more guys, probably end up seeing more objectives underneath, but at the moment, those are the guys we're going for. So, let's see what happens. Yeah, Uber Trap. Still generate me a little bit of money, not a huge amount. To be honest, if I can get these tourists in there, that would be great. If I don't, then it's not the end of the world. As long as they don't start blowing shit up, that's all I care about. And if they start blowing stuff up, then I open up the doors, and basically these cameras, these are additional cameras which I put on that you didn't see in the previous episode. So basically it covers all entrance from the base, except for maybe from the rear. We don't need to worry about that for the time being, especially in that case. There won't anybody who comes in within this area I can tag. So there you go. See, look, they've just broken out of the level 3 door. So, you know, but the thing is, if you look at their rings around them, they're both blue. So they haven't actually really seen anything incriminating. All they've got and done is basically walk through a door and just get blown round and round and round and round and round. And there's not really much to see. Now, if we look on here, aha, taking a look, what is this person? See, what is she? Okay. Now we can tag them for psychological weakening. There, no point. They'll turn up on the radar when we need to look at them. Until then, there's no point. And the good thing is that even if you leave those at level three, these guys will just go ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping. And you don't need to worry about them. They're essentially tied up in there because they're essentially they're government agents, which basically means they're not very smart. Sorry. So, let's check the world map. Right, here we go. We can go. So, oh, see, now look, 1 minute 30. 3 minutes. And 3 minutes. So 3 minutes go. 3 minutes go. And I'm going to set these guys to hide. Because what will happen is that once both of those missions complete and these guys arrive... Oh, look, another thing just got plotted out there. See, look. Oh, God. Look, do you see that? Look, flipping agents have arrived already. This could actually jeopardize my ability to run both of these missions. God damn it. That's really annoying that they just suddenly appeared like that. Oh, so annoying. But hey-ho. It's all part of the fun. It's fun, damn it, and we're going to have fun. Whether it kills them, and believe me, it will kill them repeatedly. As I will not be denied my evil. Oh, more cash cows to go into the Uber trap. Oh God, here we go. Now these are the guys you really got to watch out for. Soldiers, they come in armed, and they basically shoot everything that you can find. So they destroy all your equipment. They'll, you know, anything that looks suspicious to them, they'll try and destroy, and it's just such a pain in the ass. So what we're going to do is, unfortunately I don't have any sentries I can set up yet, but that will deal with them later. However, until then, I'm just going to keep an eye on them, because if they're not going to cause me any trouble, there's no point tagging them for anything. It's only once they start to get round the edges of the base, like this here, and also to the front, that I need to start tag them for special attention, and that attention being of the hot bullety kind. So as you can see, these guys, pong pong, and not much going on there. So, as you can see, 3 minutes, and I'm down to two valets. How much long have we got left? 1 minute 18, that's going to be tricky. I'm not sure we're going to make that one. How long we get on here? I've got plenty of guards, 1 minute and seven, so yeah. Five guards, I've still got seven guards. These guys, to be honest, I think that one's more likely to actually succeed than this one, especially as I'm now down to one. Nope, there we go. Mission failed. That's going to fail that mission because I basically lost all my valets. Thanks to these guys turning up, you gits. So fortunately, I'll be able to do that mission and then re-set up some more valets and send them in to do that mission. So what I'm going to do, actually, is put in double the amount of valets. So I'll put that up double and then I'll move that down to 36 so that we don't hit the limit there. Now, obviously, I've got a reasonable amount of money, so I will basically ramp that up so it starts bringing in the guys quickly. Sooner I get them in, sooner I'm getting trained, all the rest of it. As you can see, it's taking down the money, see, it's a significant amount, but it means that essentially I get the guys in and then I put it back down to the normal amount. So you'll see a nice conga line of minions. There we go, there's our conga line making his way into the base, ready for training and other goodness. Let's see, are they still in there? There we go. The Oriental Crime Lord. Now the thing is, when I had the patch, the mid-game patch, basically I had all these guys sitting in my area, and basically none of this was completing. So I created a new game, and I saved this as my own personal game, proceeded forward, made sure that these actually worked. So I've had that before, with a patch and other bits and pieces like that. And I only found that out on the second island about three quarters of the way through. So I had to essentially start again from scratch. That was a tough day. Indian Crime Lord has been captured. Hurrah. That was actually a bit of a surprise. I did not expect to get him. So the question is, can we get that guy? There we go. So we're going to quickly go in. As you can see, let's see how our heat is in India. See, heat's not too bad in India. This region's pretty good. Now, can we get 10 workers in there and steal that Mingy? We might be able to get the Minga. And what's that? Oh God, that's them ping-ponging again. Four valets. No, two valets and four, several guards. Yeah, we're able to do that. Put a couple of those. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we'll get that. And now the thing is, the good thing, that rug, I'll be able to place in my base and it will give stats bonuses to these guys as they walk back and through, because this is a main corridor of transit. So if I put them in there, then they're going to be getting stats increases every time they walk through that corridor. All these guys, it's going to be good. Oh crap, you know what, I just forgot staff room on the end here. So staff room with lots of recliney chairs. We love recliney goodness. There we go. So we'll put that in there, because that basically means that these guys here who want to take a break Which reminds me, that needs to be set to level 4, that needs to be set to level 4, that needs to be set to level 4. There's all the guys going abroad. Means that they don't have to go all the way back over here to relax. They can just go to here, relax, come straight back onto duty. It just makes things quicker, easier, faster, as you guys are in the... You want to have these guys... Yay! American Crime Lord. Sorry, I should have left that running. But anyway, these guys, it won't actually go ding and, you know, get you there until you're ready. Oh, this could be a problem. Now, the question is, what happens... Are they going to actually destroy anything? Correction. Oh, now see. It issued a capture tag because it's a bad people. Now, that's because of these cameras here. You can't change that. It will just automatically issue a capture tag. God, that's a mouthful. So I'm just going to set it to red alert so that they kill everybody in the room. So unfortunately they're killing loads of minions, which is not great, but hey ho. Now the thing is, what I could do is, I've got an awful lot of soldiers working here. If I switch that room off, those soldiers, the guards, will then proceed up here and assassinate everybody. You know what, it doesn't matter because they're all horribly dead. So there we go. So they've now basically been killed. Killed to death. And oh my goodness. There we go. So let's put that back to yellow alert. Silence that one. So there we go. So these guys are running for it. Unfortunately, he's probably going to get away. I'm going to get some heat off the back of that. Damn ninjas. Can't trust them. So he's going to ninja it off somewhere. This guy here will basically recover, my Dubai. He will recover once his health and everything returns to health, and or one of the guys pick him up and take him to safety. So he's going to be all right in that respect. So I don't need to worry about that. But the good news is, cha-ching! There we go, Indian subcontinent. And that one, and the thing is, there you go, Nikita Leonov, notorious butcher of St. Petersburg. If you like your ham or your meat, then he's the man to speak to. I think they're actually referring to a different kind of butcher, and not a good one. And so what we've got to do is intercept him. Now, where is he? He's around here somewhere. Oh God, soldiers, those two soldiers again. Now the thing is, they could end up shooting him with cameras. But we'll see. Let's have a look what's going on here. There's our boy. And what we want to do is wait for him to walk through there. And he is going to get the snot beaten out of him by all these guys. So, hello, hello, hello. Commence snot beatery. Go on, fight back, you pussy. Oh, there we go. Bit of fight back. And the punch-up is commenced. There we go. Punch-up is complete. Okay, these two soldiers. So, I mean, look, here they go. So they're starting to damage everything now. And that's really going to annoy me. So what I've got to do also is put a speaker up here so that it can call anybody who is Section 2. There you go. See, look, base is on fire thanks to these arsewipes. Soldiers. So as you can see, they're coming in, they're killing everybody on the case. I'm supposed to be sending my troops out, but unfortunately they're not doing anything. It's basically because there's nobody to go there and do that for them. So see that, there you go, they're shooting the cameras. See what I mean? See what I mean? This is why these soldiers get on my tits. And the thing is, what happened is these two guys are coming, trying to set the, put the fire out. And these guys are just shooting straight dead. And so you tend to lose a lot of valets. Because all they're trying to do is be good little valets and put the fire out. But instead, they're going to get shot to death. Kids. Now this should be interesting. Because what we're about to have now is a massive punch-up. Nothing like a good firefight in the middle of a corridor. Oh, lost a couple of men. Yeah, another one down there, and another one down, but I think we're on the winner. There we go, we've only got two left, one more left. You better run, girl. So, there we go. See, look, another one coming in. See, I'm going to lose all my sodding valets now. See? So what I've got to do now is... Oh, got to wait for Dubai. Where is he? Here he is. I'll have to send him in to do the damage. take these guys out because they're just destroying everything, killing all my valets. See, these guys are just coming in trying to do their job and they're going to shoot them. It's just rude, but hopefully the fire will damage them. See, look. Bloody Russians. See, look, that's that little sensor that stops him setting off the thing. But there you go. See, he's trying to go for the fire and he gets shot as well. Poor valet. Just trying to do his job and he gets shot at. So, oh, no, he's deserted. Sorry, mate. Anyway, you leave my organisation is in a flipping body bag. Come on, chop him into fish bait, fish bait, fish bait. Here come the cavalry. Bit too late as usual. Thanks, cavalry. Here we go. One's dead. The other one. Here we go. And it looks like Dubai's leveled up. There we go. The Russians are down. Goits. So, oh, put that one in there. Put that one in there. That one. That one. So they'll take care of that. And which reminds me, what I want to do is until I'm ready, I want to switch off the autosave. So there we go. Sorry about that. So there we go. Now, Dubai's just leveled up, so we're going to give him the Eviscerate ability. There we go. He's now learned to Eviscerate, which is basically chop them into fish bait a lot more efficiently. Now, the thing is, this is the guy that we've got to interrogate. See, so how he's a Russian with that afro, I have no idea. So, what we've got to do is put him in the human mixer. So, we've selected him to be mixed. And we are going to move over here. Put that up to basic operations. Not a lot of people in it. Not really fast. Oh, there are the guys at the sinister conference table. Waiting for a sinister conference, obviously. What else would you have on a sinister conference table? But a sinister conference. Okay, I'm rambling. So, let's see. Now, as you can see, I've already taken out that thing there, and I'll probably end up building other stuff there as and when I need it. There you go. The purple bench is flying around. So, she'll... unfortunately, we don't have any gas in here yet. Once we start getting research in, we'll be able to research gas. Once we get the knockout gas in, I'll be able to add that to the circuit, and you guys will be able to see that basically we tone them from not very bright people to even less bright people with the combination of gas, loyalty gas, and then if we want to cull the herd, then we put poison gas in there as well, but that doesn't matter. Now, the thing is, who is coming to interrogate this guy? Go on. See, I'm trying to get them to interrogate him. See, there we go. That's the interrogation thing. Now, where is the other stuff? Let's get back onto the main stage. Here we go. Have I got enough people to do that? I have. Go. And have I got enough people to do that? I haven't. Damn it. Any more workers? Oh, God, I've hardly got any bloody workers left now. Thanks for that mass assassination session by the bloody soldiers. So turning that up to full, and we'll get about another 30 odd agent minions in, and that will mean that I can then start chucking the minions out onto the world stage and basically solve that problem there. Now what's going on here? Oh, that looks nice. Four technicians. I've only got six available and lots of workers, so we'll have to see what happens there. That'll be a very nice thing to have, because then you get to... What happens is later on, when you have research, the scientists walk around and check out what's going on. Now, this is going to be quite good. Essentially, here comes the Russian, and he is basically... We are going to not interrogate him, but torture him.
This is the Pan-Arabic Wireless Service at 8 o'clock.
Come on, get in the bowl. In the bowl. So he's in the bowl, and wave goodbye. And he's getting mixed right in the mixers. So.
Bye.
So we're mixing him, basically, to get him on our side. Because, I mean, who doesn't use a, you know, food mixer as a device of torture? I mean, all the cool countries do it, obviously. You know, what can you say? So, let's just turn that back down to zilch. Now that we've got our 36 men back in. Now, what are these guys? These guys are just standard agents, not really a threat. So, that's taken. Good, good. We can't do that yet because we don't have any spin doctors. We'll find out later as we unlock them. And over here, there are workers required, so we'll put some workers in there. How many do we need? We need three technicians, so we'll put four in there. So then what we'll be able to do is we'll do that one and then hopefully that one straight afterwards. Now, what's in this? What do we need for that? Let's get some workers in there, 10 workers in there. And now we've got two valets, four guards, and lots of workers, so hopefully we should be able to go blump blump, do those both of those missions. Now the thing is, as we go down this list here, see, Nikita, what's his face there? We're just gonna, well, after we've mixing bowled him, which I think is still in progress. Yep. Mixing is still in progress. We are mixing up a tonic for him. Let me just add in these into the circuit. So it goes in there, and that goes in there. That goes in there, that goes in there. Now the thing is, with this unofficial patch, it basically means that what I'm looking to do is... Oh, naughty people. Hello. I don't have a lot of soldiers in this area, so let's just assassinate. Essentially, what I'm looking to do is to try and develop sentries for both outside and inside. Now, the advantage of that, inside means I can defend certain key areas, and that will become very important in something in here later, you'll find out. But primarily, I can use it as a way to defend my entrance to my base. So here, I'll just put sentry guns, stop people approaching, and basically go on this mass murder spree with sentry guns, and who doesn't want to see that? So... let's put these things back in that the bloody soldiers blew up. Selfish gits. There we go! Nikita, what's-his-face, has been mixed. And he's looking a lot better for it, as the guy's playing ping-pong in the background, doing something important. I mean, such a stereotype, look at that. The afro with a flipping comb in it as well, just... can't say I've seen a lot of Russians like that, but never mind. Anyway. Now, as you can see, that's looking pretty good there. Let's have a look. Optional objective, American totem pole, we'll need to get to that. So, once Nikita, what's-his-face, is in position, we could have a new objective, but we'll wait and see what happens. See, now I'll put that glass door in there, because I like that, and I like also setting that to level 4, because then it's, you can see what's going on, but you can't actually get in there, which is kind of tantalizing. So... anyway, let's see what happens. Now, it could be that I'm not going to get it because I don't have enough reputation, but I guess we'll find out. Correction! Oh, Nigel Ewing. Any relation to Dallas? CIA agent. Okay, if I'm not notorious enough, I'll never find him. So he's cruising off the Nile, which basically means this area here. So... as you can see, this would be the area where, you know, the Nile would be and all the rest of it. So there's, you've got Egypt and all that funky stuff. Now, the question is, can we get that? Yes, we can. Go. So, we're going to go for that. And let's see what we've got here. What? Burgles? Where's the burgles? Who's burgling? Oh, they're burgling. There we go. Now, see, he's got a backpack, so he's probably just burgling money. So I'm going to have to send my guys after him, but they're probably going to fly away with my money, which is just cruel. So what I'm going to do is set him to eviscerate. That guy. Yay, we have a Ming. Ming-tastic. Now, where's the Ming? Where's the Ming? Ming, 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 Ming. Ah, here we go. So we've had to switch that to level 2. Bring out the Ming. And put the Ming there. So basically, as they walk through, they'll get all the goodness of the Ming. So I don't think I'm going to catch these guys. See, I think Jubai... Has he stopped following them? Oh, you lazy git. Oh, well. We're going to lose a small amount of money, to be honest. It's not the end of the world. He's going to have a bit of a punch-up. He's running back to his base. I don't think he's stolen anything massively important, but it's going to give me some heat that I don't really want, but it doesn't matter. It's not the end of the world. It's more notoriety, which I'm happy for. Oh, crikey, has it taken two technicians? Jesus, it has as well. Bloody hellfire. That's pretty harsh. Okay, take the rug. And let's see. Four technicians, so we're stepped down on technicians. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put 20 technicians in. and then drop that down until that capacity starts staying red. There we go. So we should cover that. So as you can see, Agent... Oh, bloody hell. Not sodding soldiers again. If you do control and select them on the west bit, basically select the entire squad as soon as they land. Come on, Dubai. Get your flipping the bony ass out there and start shopping people into fish bait. Goddamn soldiers. Piss me off. And the thing is, they're going to flipping reduce this thing to a flaming wreck. And that's the last thing I need right now. So, red alert, boys and girls. Red alerts. Get out of there, kids. I'm going to put a flipping speaker there so I can summon these guys when I need to. Congratulations, I've acquired a rug. Hooray. Where the sudden hell is it? Yeah, okay, whatever. Where is that rug? Ooh-woo! Ruggy! Ruggy, ruggy, ruggy! Wherefore art thou, rug? Ugh, God's sake. Oh, look, there's a tourist walking right through the sodding middle of it all. That is ridiculous. It could be this. Ah, here we go. Ah! Maybe that's what they stole. So let's put the rug there. And once that's moved, we'll delete that thing. So, as you can see, tourist in the middle. More money being taken to bring workers in. See, look, just dying as soon as they get out there. It's just so annoying. Here we go, the cavalry. Oh my goodness, the cavalry's on its way. Come on, boys. Come on, lads. See, look, they're flipping blowing up me. Look, they're blowing up me new flipping things already. Get in there and kick those soldiery arses. Where are they from? Oh, they're all flipping Chinese, I think, or something like that. I'm going to gun every single bloody one last of them down. Come on. Let's see. Yeah, no, don't. Oh, for God's sake. Just because you've killed one of them doesn't mean that there's not more of them. Oh, you. See. On guard duty. You're not supposed to be on guard duty. You're supposed to be killing these bloody guys. Stupid great pillocks. And look. Now, this... long hair bint is attacking my flipping stuff. Oh God, I'm gonna kill all of them. I'm gonna kill them all to death. Destroy my stuff like that. It's just rude. You know what? I'm gonna put it to one and one and just get in there, get blown around, annoy stuff, blow things up. I can afford to remake it, and I hope you'll die horribly. Bastards. Blowing up my stuff. Rude. Okay, so one valet down, and we don't have another valet to go in there. And I've got a moth who's bugging around and starting to annoy me. Because I'm getting evil genius rage. My evil will not be denied. I will get this universe. If it takes every single one of their lives, I will take it. Oh joy, everything's on fire. Yes, walk away. Step away from the fire. No. Go back there. Yes. Just go back there and do things. Come on. Here we go. 31 men. Put that back to zero. Come on. You're supposed to be chopping them into fish bait. Don't bonsai me. Just get in there and cut them to pieces. Oh, God. I swear I have idiots for minions. I suppose that's because they are minions, really. You don't really employ them for their intelligence. You employ them for their cannon fodder specialities. Okay, yeah, you know what? You're pissing me off, too. So, you're a tourist. You can be now a package, a special package holiday to a morgue of your choice. Back to yellow alert. Is that more so... See, this is the problem that I had when I was playing my game earlier, is that just soldiers, and they end up basically blowing up all my stuff. Now, obviously, this is going to... This, as you can probably tell, this is starting to get on my tits. However, my evil plans will not be derailed by this temporary setback. Bloody troglodytes. anyway. Let's see how many men I've got. See, 20 or 31, that'll be all right for the time being. So as you can see, look, their stats being increased, being improved. Obviously, they're carrying body bags, so their stats do go down. But as you can see, there you go, a couple of arrows down and up. Their counteracts are down and up. So that's good. Congratulations, Jubai. You are now... Oh, here we go. Ninjas, more sodding ninjas. You know what? Just get in there and snuff it already. Just sick to death of you. Some stupid bit running around in a bikini. Yeah, whatever. So you can run around in your bikini, but the thing is, what they're going to do is they're going to go in there and they're going to basically blow all this crap up. They're going to have to rebuild it, and then there we go. See, there we go. Get blown around. Get me some money in my bank. You're annoying me. It's only fair I get some compensation back for the pain in the ass that you are. There he is, bloody moth again. I might have to do a bit of emergency moth assassination. Give me a second. Moth is no more. Assassinations has been completed. And he looks significantly flatter than he did 5 seconds ago. Anyway. So, a little bit of a virtual assassination and in real life assassination for you. Courtesy of Chadtopia. Can't beat it, can you? Anyway. So, returning back to what's going on, here come the soldiers. Now, they're going to come in from there. Have I got many soldiers on guard? I don't have a huge amount. I've got some there, and I've got none in my control room. To be honest, I don't really care about that. We've got more soldiers training up, as you can see. But, what is going on here? Is it, look, ninjas going back and forth. Great. Wonderful. Knock yourself out, boys. You're going to go round, generate me money, and I'm going to be a happy bunny. Now, the thing is, these guys are the threat. Now, it's good that I've got a load of soldiers there, because if that's on the right circuit, which it is, as soon as I mark these guys for death, march for death, I will basically have all these guys charge out, and we'll have a great big huge gunfight, and it'll be wonderful. So, they're going to go in there. Yes, they are. There we go. So, there we go. They're now shooting. So, here we go. Here come my lads. Here come the cavalry. They're coming out to do the gunny thing. So, out comes Jubai. Fish bait time. And he's going in there to... Yeah, just don't run away from the battle. Get in there and shoot them. Have I lost a few guards? Yeah, I've lost a couple of guards. But most of these soldiers are being eliminated. Now, he's running for it. But I don't think he's going to run for it very far. What's his health? Oh, he's got 13 health. Now, can Jubai catch him in time before he gets back to base and generates loads of heat for me? That's questionable, because you can see Jubai's a little bit slower. Can he make it in time? No, he can't. God damn it. So he's going to make it away, give me some heat, which basically means I'll get more agents. Slightly annoying, but you know what? It's not a huge crisis as far as I'm concerned. Let's see. And put that one in there. There we go. So we are returning to status quo in the matter of my Uber trap. So that should stay at level 3. And let's get some more pressurous paddles in here. And let's have a look. Boom, 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 boom. And then we'll put a new camera in here to point down the corridor so at least I can notify people if there's, you know, evil goings on there. So let's see. So, as you can see, my mat's in place. The mattress is in places and looking good, as you can see. Giving benefit to my guys as they walk past. This is all the main area. So this is great. I'm very happy about this. However, I'm not going to get Nigel Ewing because I don't have enough notoriety. So, we're going to go for the oil leak. And then obviously these guys are all plotting. Now what I'm going to do is put a couple of soldiers in there. And let's see, technicians. We needed some technicians for this, didn't we? Yes. So we'll get 5 technicians in there. And, oh crap, no workers. So let's get in and get the money up quickly. Get the workers in as quickly as possible. Now that my concern is the fact that this money's going down. If I get some people in my Uber trap, like the tourists and stuff like that, that money will start increasing. The more people you get in Uber trap, the better it is. The more money making is generated. So let's see, missions running there, that hopefully should be successful. Technicians, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, there we go. Bring those in here. I need to get some guys in here. plotting. Oh, I need to get some guys there. Plotting. So. All quiet. Oh, I need to get some... Oh, crap. Can't put them in there because I don't have enough. Actually, what I'll do is I'll put those guys in there. Oil leak has been successful. So, active infamy. Now, let's check out our infamy. There you go. Boss man, 51. Heating this area is pretty high because I've already done two missions here. So, as you can see, it's just with guards and valets and all the rest of it. So let's see what's going on here. Three technicians. One, two, three. How many workers? No, I can't put any more workers in there. Bugger. All the workers are going to go in there. So at the moment, I'm kind of struggling for numbers. Oh, crap. I've lost all my valets. Bloody soldiers. So what I've got to do is go down and capture this bin again. But what I could do is... Let me just check. What's that mission? There we go. Let's capture her. Let's do that mission quickly so we can get the maid and the valets back and we don't have to go through all this crap again. But to be honest, soldiers will always end up destroying. Oh, look! Look at this! More soldiers! Ah, the Honourable Seeker soldiers. Now, what's going on here? Agents? Yes, they are. Can I get them sniffing in there? And get them in with the ninjas? Because then we can have a bird and ninja party, and who wouldn't want to have one of them? However, my minions do not appear to be doing much. See, they're all wandering around. Let's see what's going on here. Let's put that down to a lower level. So we don't have so many guys standing around. Yeah, let's just put that to level one. One of the ninjas might escape, but I don't care. But if it captures two of these birds, I'll be happy. There we go. Two birds captured. Now, how much heat has he got? He's seen nothing. He's seen nothing. No red line around him at all. So he can basically disappear into the goodness, into the darkness. And I don't give a toss. Okay. I seem to have screwed that up. There we go. So, as you can see, they're on the way to the hospital. So that's looking good. Looking spangly. Now, if I can only get a few tourists into this area here. Now, the advantage of that basically means that they'll, as soon as you lock the door behind them, they'll panic and they'll run around. They'll keep setting these traps off and sending these guys around and generate me money, which is what I want. I want money. I want Wonga. If you're not going to give it to me, you're no good to me whatsoever. Let's get him sitting at the conference table, waiting for the remainder. Well, we're still waiting for Nigel Ewing, whoever the flippin' hell he is. Alright, come on. Come on, girl. There we go. Headmaid has been kidnapped. And what we're going to do is get those two in there. One, two. Keep them plotting. Now, the question is, yes, we can go in and get the Sound of Music. What we've got up here, that's where we get the guard from if we need it again. And then over here, we've got the other mission with the technicians and then more workers, so we can't really afford to get any more workers, so we'll see how that mission goes there. As you can see, down to 9, see, so it's generating me money, which is what I want. I don't really want to keep going down in the money factor, as that would annoy me. You see, my piles of gold are getting smaller, and that's just not on. Thing is, by the time I move to the second island, I want to have that flipping room full. Each of these stacks, about 400,000, I think. So each of these stacks basically represents 400,000. So, as you can see, it's all quiet. I've been able to turn off the control room. Means I won't get the feedback on missions and everything that I want. But what it means is that the amount of guards that become available and start guarding this area here, as you can see, there's not a huge amount of them guarding. There you go, the Sound of Music has been successful. So there you go, there's the Sound of Music. So we'll bring that down here and put it about there. A little bit of overlap, so that will help improve things as these guys walk through here. Now, that's an active infamy, also good. Get the technicians out of there. And unfortunately, as you can see, I lost quite a few minions there, so yeah, more money. So you can clunk, 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 clunk. Yeah, all the money goes down again. You can change it, so it's like 1,000 every 20 seconds, so it's not as bad. But to be honest, I just want to get as many in as quickly as possible. That'll do for the time being. So here we go. Oh, bloody hell, soldiers again. and start shooting all this brand new stuff. Come on. Go on, start. Yeah, there we go. Oh, two bunches of soldiers? Are you taking the piss? Red alert, red alert. I do not want this many sodding soldiers in my Uber trap. You know what? Level one, door, go through it, get blown around. Just don't blow my shit up. And don't, see, look, they're just going to keep destroying that because it sets things off. Yeah. Nothing but an utter sodding annoyance. See, technician comes in to try and repair things, gets shot. This is what annoys me about soldiers. See, more goings on. See, another. More soldiers, yet again. More soldiers. See, this is the trouble we get in heat, is they're sending in soldiers to actually do damage to me. And they are doing damage to me. They're getting on my nerves. And I will kill every single one of them. I'm not going to be happy until I'm knee-deep in their corpses. So at least they're going round now and generating money. Even though they're setting all this crap off, it's not going to be good. They're blowing the door up. See, look, they'll go round, they'll set that off again. See, more fire, flamey death, blah, 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 and they'll start running for it. So at least they'll generate me a little bit of money while they're going round and round and round. So it's not the end of the world, but to be honest, I don't want any of my troops going there doing any of this stuff. I have to switch all that off. And off, and off, and off. Because we need to now wait. See, look, dude. See, look. More people. Just assassination left, right, and center. I'm losing guys like you have no idea. This is not good. And see, there you go. See, look. There's a maid. I do not have the time to get the flipping maid so I can get a doodah, a valet, so we can put the sodding fires out. But to be honest, it's best off just to let it burn. Some people just want to watch the world burn, and I don't, because this is my flipping stuff, you gits. Flipping Russians again, my God. They really do not know how to take a hint. I tell you, you boys are going to come in for such a cropper when I get my turrets. Because when I get my turrets, you guys are just going to get absolutely air-conditioned with bullets. And I cannot wait for every glorious sodding moment when that occurs. Yeah, come on, Dubai. Just fish bait them, fish bait them. Come on. Come on. Come on. See, look, just... See, look at that. Just, like, lost 20 of my flipping minions almost immediately. And there we go. One Russian guy is down. And you've got the Sikhs over there. And at least that's being protected. So you've got technicians out there who are going to try and basically repair all this shit. Let's just delete that. Let's delete that. Delete that. Delete that. Because basically what's going to happen, they're going to catch fire, set fire, set fire. And I've got nobody to put the fire out. That's essentially the issue. Let us get a valet as quickly as possible. But the trouble is, he's not going to go training. Basically, he's going to see a fire and he's going to go straight for the fire. So there's not really a lot I can do in that respect. Oh, technician, that's right, have a punch up and get killed very quickly, you idiots. There we go, another soldier out there, or just a guard, I should say. Yeah, you can run around screaming, you stupid cow. Because I've got technical problems. See what I mean? Look, there we go. So, that'll blow up, and then that'll catch fire, and then... Dubai can learn a new special ability. That's an awesome ability that he has. Windwalk. Basically, it means he can teleport anywhere on this area. Now, what we can do is get him to... There we go. You see that? Straight in there. Boom. He's right in, and he's going for these guys. Now, the thing is, there we go. Come on, chop him, chop him. They're probably going to escape. Yeah, more heat, joy, more soldiers. Now, they're making a run for it. So, let's see what happens. Yeah, corpses, money everywhere, corpses, corpses, corpses.
I need silk cut.
These will stop some of them. Get the troops back in. What's going on? Have we got Nigel Ewing yet? More to the point, have we got that flipping maid sorted out? Come on. See, I've got no minions to bloody support her. We'll get her interrogated. That moo. As you can see, one of them got away. So that means, as you can see, heat pretty goddamn high there, heat pretty high there. See, look, heat off the bloody scale in Africa and off the scale in the Middle East. So I'm getting a lot of pressure. Couple of workers in there, a bit more notoriety. See, Bossman 57. Those guys are still plotting. And see, little to no guards left. See, 12 out of 40. So what we're going to do, just try and get as many men as possible. It means they might be able to accommodate them, but the point is I'm getting guys in as quickly as possible, and it means that I can then get them trained up as quickly as possible, and it'll give me lots of cannon fodder, or as 77Y Malachite likes to call them, cadets, and that will help things. So let's just see what happens. Here we go, conga line of newbies, all good stuff. Yeah, you can shut up, woman. Yeah. Tag that wench. Hostile presence? What? What? Where? Oh, it's because she was on the camera, that's why. Okay, so. But, see, look. Yeah, because I got those. Switch off. Delete. So what we can do now is hopefully new door. Now the trouble is, you see, what happens later on is that I'm going to get the ability to create a area to set this trap off, so that you don't have to put any of these sensors in, and it will get automatically set off on a regular basis. So they've got no pads in which to destroy. The only thing they'll destroy is a door, which with any luck they won't get to, because they'll keep going round and round and round. That's later on. That's with a an upgrade that we'll get as a result of other stuff. So we'll just have to wait and see what happens. See, they're in again doing nothing. We need to go to Japan to really start sniffing some stuff out there. Plot. Plotorama. Plotity-doo-dah. Plot. Do love some plotting. Can't beat a good plot. Okay, plots. There we go. So as you can see, I'm trying to get people out to flip and get rid of those before. Thing is, if those explode, not the end of the world, but they won't set fire to anything else. It's not too bad. But the thing is, the reason why I put pads there is because guys get caught up in between that section, and it's good because they walk back and forth, and then it sets off basically the Uber trap and sends these guys who are still in there going round. So hopefully, if I can get some kind of... Oh, look, there's the valet, who's not going to be training anyone. He's going to be putting fires out. Now, if that explodes and kills him, I'm going to be pissed. See, there's one gone up. Come on, Mr. Valet. See, there's no bloody fire to put out. Congratulations, you're too sodding late. You steaming great pillock. One, two, three. So let's get building our flipping pressure pads and bits and bobs again, because they always stand at the front there like that. And we'll put some poison dirt. Let's put the poison gas trap in so we can clear it out if we have to. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2. 1, 2. Make me sound like I'm doing sound check. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Why is it sound check people can never count beyond two? What's this? Is more soldiers? No, just standard, bog standard agency people. Okay. So, more training. Training is continuing. We only have 10 guards, but we have quite a few minions Let's up that a bit and then get the rest of those minions in there. We won't be able to accommodate all of them, but to be honest, I don't care. They're just cannon fodder. I just need to get them in to get these guys up to the right level that I want them to get, and then we can go from there. Which I might put up to 50 guards. So I get as many guards as I can possibly manage. See, down at 710 grand, that's not good. Not good at all. Especially as I'm going to have to start building loads of crap. And it's all because these selfish gits here keep destroying stuff. Which is just uncalled for. Now, where is Dubai? Because I want to send him in to Windwalk. And eviscerate. Chop him into fish baits. Now the trouble is because that. Yeah, whatever. Come on, fish bait him. Oh, that's good.
They cannot defeat me with their slender arms.
Come on, fish bait him. Come on. What's taking him? Now the trouble is, obviously, technician has deserted my organization. No deserting for you, Sunshine. No desert for you. Oh, God. Quick. Get him before he runs away. Oh, crap. He's going to make it. Nuts. Normally, people aren't allowed out of my organization unless they're in the body bag. And he's made it a bugger. So that might cause me some problems later on down the line. Yay! More soldiers! I bet they're Chinese. No, they're the Sikhs again. Wow, these guys are really pissed that I've got this boy. This boy here. Maybe it's, no, it's this guy, yeah. So, never mind. As you can see, the power is great. Everything relating to power, we're really good. You've got loads of power here, we've got loads of power here, plenty of batteries. That's not an issue. The issue is essentially defending my base and trying to make sure that my Uber trap stays up for more than 30 seconds. Tall order, I'm sure I hear you cry. However, I am determined. There you go, that's blocking the object, so essentially you can't put that down until that body bag is out of the way. So you gotta just wait, just let them get on with it. Let's sort it out, somebody pick up the body bag, drag it away and do whatever they need to do. So not fussed a bit. Put that one link, and just leave it like that for the time being. No point until they build the rest of it. My loyal minions. Kind of loyal. Now the thing is, has Mr. Ewing, has JR turned up yet? Who shot JR? Nobody knows, nobody cares. Okay, let's see what's going on there. That's a lot of technicians. But what I need to do is get some people back in the control room. They can tell me what kind of risk it is and therefore how my notoriety will improve. So let's see what we get as a result of that. Yes. See, that's the only drawback with this. It will spam it until it gets rid of this body bag. So if we put that there now, and then obviously, there we go, pick up that body bag, and then they can start putting that stuff in. Hooray! This is good news. Oh, dear. Internet phlegm ejection. We enjoy it. Sorry about that. Apologies. Oh, God. Clean me out, that one. So as you can see, talking to somebody as well at the same time. Multi-talented me. Nah, not really. You know what? Stop running around, just start kneeling on me. So, serves him right for wearing that silly hat. So, now that's back up and running, we can put everything back together. Put our link in place. And there we go, moving that in. Sorry about the sneeze, I've been sneezing most of the day, I don't know why. Maybe I'm coming down with something, that'd be nice. Oh dear. And what we do is we'll say, bring that back to there. That so I don't want that affecting people, because what will happen is agents will come up, take pictures of that and go, ooh, that's interesting, get suspicious, generate heat, blah blah blah, and then look, here are all the soldiers to set fire to everything again. Oh, that's a point. Is that up? Yes it is. Let's get another one of these in. See, look at my money. That's not good.
Object has been ordered.
I need to get this at least established and get that flipping Nigel Ewing in there, because until I don't think I've got enough notoriety. Seeing I'm only at 57 notoriety, so he's not going to show up no matter how much I plot like a mofo. So what I've got to do is I've got to do more missions. I need to find the ones that are quick and easy and cheap. Now these guys are going to plot. Yep, they're plotting. And what's here? 6 valets. I've only got 1. 10 workers. Let's put that one in. Give them 12. Can't do that one because I need mercenaries. Don't have mercenaries yet. Let's see what we've got here. They're plotting. Plot there more. Plot. Plot. There's only one guy plotting there, so we need more plotage. And let's see. He's plotting and he's only one as well. So what's this one here? 2 valets, 1 technician, 1 guard. Now, I don't have a lot of anybody really, to be honest. So let's see. Look, 2 technicians, 1 valet. Not good. Not good at all. So, the trouble is, where are all these guys going? This is not good. There we go.
Kill card issued.
It's bad at the max!
Oh, wow. See, that's the only trouble with hard levels. These guys hit pretty hard. You get. At least at easy level, you cut these guys down like fish bait. Yep, let me guess. My only valet, yeah. Slightly annoying, see? And they start blowing my shit up. You know what? What I'm tempted to do is literally just put a flipping door in here and then delete this corridor so then we can get into it until such times as I can secure things. Because at the moment, I'm not getting much joy. See, I've got nobody. I've got absolutely bloody nobody at the moment. Only 11 guards who are out on the field. Not many flipping minions. See, 59, 60 minions. But nobody to defend anything, man. This is really annoying. So he's going to come in and get shot pretty quickly. Actually, didn't even manage to pick up the body bag. Now the thing is, can we get... No, they're going to set fire. They're going to shoot all of that. So. Okay. The trouble is notoriety is a double-edged sword, because what it means is that I get more notoriety, but I also then get more attention. And it's not such a good thing as you might imagine. See, there's one there. I see 8 technicians. I don't even have one at the moment. Can't do that one. Doing that one, not yet. See, I need 2 valet and I don't have any available because they just died. Actually, no, to be honest, we're going here. We're going to get her back there. Question is, does that give me any kind of... No, it doesn't, but I think it does. So, what's caught fire? Yay, everything. Bastards. Don't get me wrong, I'm a huge supporter of the armed forces, just not when they're attacking on the base. See, look. There we go. See, look, they start attacking. Oh, well done. And then all this will catch fire. And you know what? My valet could come in and put it all out. But no, he's dead already. So, slightly frustrating, but, you know, I refuse to give up. I will refuse to be dented by these troglodytes who know nothing of my grand plan. And when the boot is on the other foot, I shall laugh long and heartily, because I'm going to bitch slap you bastards so hard. You're going to be like a seaside village after the Vikings have just been. It's going to be horrific. See, at least they're going around. See, look, at least they're generating money. Makes up for all the stuff they're setting on bloody fire. 3960, no valets. One technician is being trained. Body bags left, right and centre. Are those more troops? See what I mean? See what I mean? And it's those guys again. Wow. Is it India? I don't even actually have a lot of heat in the Indian subcontinent, so why are they actually coming after me with such an vengeance? That's what I don't understand.
Citizens in all smash territories are being urged to remain
silent as
the spate of kidnappings continues.
Because we do enjoy a spate of kidnappings, right? What have we got there? Samurai sword swindle and 8 technicians, so we have to leave that. I want to get that one because that's quite an easy one to get. And it will help, so... As you can see, tourist, yeah, whatever, catch fire, die horribly, I don't care. Now, I bet Dubai's the only one around. Yeah, he's off doing his thing, God only knows what. So, as you can see, soldiers, training. Not a lot of people available to take on these gits. At least because everything is on red alert, these guys are shoot on sight. So that makes my life significantly easier. But go eviscerate. Come on, fish bait them. Fish bait those buggers. Come on. Chop them. Chop and slice. Chop and slice. Don't forget your moves. Chop and slice. Here we go. Oh, na- oh. Here come the rest of them. You know what? Most people would normally give up at this point. Not me. I refuse. I will not give up. It's difficult. It's annoying. It's frustrating. But I will prevail. For your sake, but mostly for mine. You know what? Doorway. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to put a door in there and I'm going to delete that corridor. So I'm going to put a door in here, door in there, and delete that corridor. Can I get rid of that? No, I can't. And then I just delete that corridor, nobody can enter there, and then I can just leave it until such times as my money's improved. I can defend everybody coming in this direction and then basically deal with that issue. Okay, so what can I do here? See, technicians is 3, workers 2. Oh, bloody hell, is that all? Is that all the workers I've got? Oh god, I'm spending more money. More money. So, what we're doing is we just, what the hell? Okay, that's a really, really bad domain name. Blindsuck.net. Wow. So anyway, there you go, everything's blown up, so great, wonderful. Blow everything up, do whatever you need to do, I really don't give a toss. I will get everything back up and running. Actually, you know what? Screw it. I'm just going to leave those doors in there and then take them out later if I have to. I'll put in these doors again, too. Put a single camera. Actually no, I've got to put in double cameras. Now the thing is, for those of you who are curious about the difficulty levels and how they vary, easy level you get 25% discount on everything you spend. Normal level everything's about the same price as it originally was in the game, and hard level basically means everything is 25% more expensive. So now the thing is, all that's happening is I'm generating a load of heat but not a lot of notoriety, and that's a problem for me at the moment. Let's see what we can do over here. 7 workers, there we go, put those in, put 10 workers in there. And what do these guys need? Need a couple of guards, we'll put 4 guards in there, good stuff. So basically what I should be able to do is basically get a little bit of notoriety there, and I might be able to actually do some more plotting in here and actually get Nigel Ewing, what's his face, to show up. Now let's do plotting there. Send a couple in there as well. And do a bit of plottage there. There we go. We enjoy the plottage. What are these guys? Yeah, they're going for the... Yeah, God, they're going for it. You know what? Screw you guys. I'm going to kill all of you. Oh, there we go. Come on, kill them. Just get on with it. Just kill them already. Plebs. See, look, it's all burning. It's all burning horribly. Yeah, just go in there, do whatever you want. I don't care. Yep, assassinate, assassinate, kill. Terminate with extreme prejudice. Because I know we am. There we go. Hi. So as you can see, money situation not great. Let's get her back so we get more valets. We need our valetish. What the... See, I'm just using up too many goddamn workers. This is the problem. Get that in again. Get 10 more workers. Put them in there. Get a bit more notoriety. And then hopefully I can then start making a stand against these bloody soldiers. Is that more soldiers I see? This is only three of them, so maybe the heat's starting to dissipate. It could be that I need to leave it for a while and just like go to bed for an hour or two and let the heat dissipate, and then I can start getting the notoriety that I want to get. So at the moment they might just look around and see nothing, but if they go into the main base then at least Dubai can deal with them, which in my opinion is a good thing. So. All these guys, see, look at that, only half a million, that's really not good. Really not good at all. See, look, the stack of gold there, really small. I want that goddamn room filled with money and gold. See, look, they're going to go for all this again. See, look, there you go. There you go. Of course the bloody object blocked your fool. Idiots, I tell you, idiots.
Heron rising sword technique.
Yeah, whatever, get on with it. Tell me, just the mass assassination. That's what makes it funny, my control room is completely empty. Because I have no people here. So... it's time to get people back. Sorry guys. Good. That's our crisis.
Remember, all other radio stations are banned. If you listen to them, you are betraying El Presidente. Viva Presidente!
Viva Presidente!
Rumors that a horde of evil persons have committed an atrocity in our beloved Cuba. El Presidente would like to make it known that these rumors are false, and any evidence to the contrary is merely coincidence. On
has made a request for Hammer for more troops.
Well, with any luck, all the soldiers are dead. Yes, they are, for at least for the now. And we can concentrate on getting our shit together. Oh no, they're running away. Good. But they got little to no heat on them. Even though they're taking a lot of shots. Doesn't matter. Okay. So, doors in place. If I need to delete that corridor, I can do exactly that. So that means basically my notoriety is going up some here. And we'll continue to plot, so as you can see, I'm sly. As you see, valets. We've got the valet back in again. So, what happens now? See, so from a building point of view, it's actually been a thoroughly boring episode. Because, essentially, I haven't really built much, or I've not really done a lot. What I've done is spent most of my time defending my Uber trap from attacks by soldiers. Not really what I call riveting. Obviously, some of you guys might be laughing at my annoyance, but that's a whole different discussion in itself. So we'll just have to wait. Now, what I'm going to do is leave those as level twos. You see, light comes out there, isn't it lovely? I cannot wait to get a disguised base entrance on there, so they won't keep poking around there. Let's see what's going on. You've got guys there, a couple of maids. Oh, a bit of Lara Croft going on there. Those are my guys. See, all we're waiting for is one bloody guy. Just waiting for this one flipping guy to poke his nose out, and then I can capture him, and I can progress. But I don't have enough notoriety, because I haven't done enough missions. So I need to get my shit sorted. So, workers, put 10 workers in there. No, can't do that one. Can't do that one, don't have the technicians yet. Can I do that one? One technician, yes we can. 4 technicians go out there. 8 technicians for that one. 3 workers, 3 guards, 3 valets. No, not enough valets yet. We need to get the valet level up. So what we might do is essentially take a shot on the chin, so to speak. See, look, they're fucking destroying the damn thing already. Look. Selfish bitches. Right, Jubai. I need you, man. Chop these bints into fish bait.
At the max.
I don't care how fit she looks. She is not blowing my shit up. Come on. Serves you right, you sneaky cow.
God.
Don't remember women being that annoying. Anyway. He is naughty. He needs killing. Has he seen something? Fortunately, the camera's detected that, which is good news. Good news indeed. So, you know what? But once they get moved out, I will destroy that corridor for the time being. That'll give me a little bit of something to play with around defending my base. And then, essentially, I won't do any acts of infamy, and I'll just try and build up my forces back to their original size so that I can then rest from there, so that if I get attacked by loads of soldiers, I can defend myself. But the trouble is, getting the guys in for the Uber trap is quite helpful, especially ones like that. Means that I can essentially get them in, and it will start generating money for me. But No, I need to get the troops in, because until I get this area guarded, any calls that come from here, that's going to be empty. There's going to be nobody running in. There's 14 guards, 7 technicians, valets. I need 20 valets. I need 20 technicians. I need those 50 guards to be able to do anything. So it's not good. I need to do that first and focus on that, which basically means people like this, dead. Dead as a doornail. Nope, don't shoot the valet. Do not shoot the bloody valet. Don't you friggin' dare. Come on, Jubai, get your sordid ass out there. Don't shoot my little valet. You better be going to train people. He is. Good lad. Good boy. He's off to train people. Oh, for God's sake. Well, what do you know? That's unexpected. Sorry, there you go. See, look, they're shooting them already. Dubai, where are you? Come on. See, look, there's just too many of them and you can't kill them all. He's going to go back. Returning to HQ. Flathead Wonder. There we go, more heat, more troops. Ugh. So, as you can see, it's not really been a massive success so far. They're going to come in and shoot my shit up again. Bastards. And I'm going to be out of pocket again. Until such times as I go in and do that. And that. So a couple of missions, maybe get a little bit more notoriety. I'll look up, I think up I might need 100 notoriety, I'm not 100% certain. Or it might be 75, I don't know, for this Nigel Ewing, this slippery CIA agent to turn up in area of Nile and all that kind of crap. We shall see. Philosopher's Stone, thank you. Now, did I just see? I did! There's our boy. Get him. Go. Sooner I can get him in, the sooner I can start getting other things. There you go, Nigel Ewing. We're going for him now. So as you can see... Oh, for God's sake. If they set anything on fire, I am not... I'm basically going to lock my door so nobody can get out. Because I don't care. I don't want to lose my valet again. Let's just check. Yep. Radio.
This is Pacific FM, and I'm Larry Driscoll, keeping you up to date with regional events from California all the way up to Alaska.
Story excellent, on everyone's I can get
list
you.
Today is the big felony committed earlier. No one knows who's responsible yet, but everyone's got a theory. Isn't that right, Bill? Haha, yeah. Even the penguins in Alaska.
No, I'm
going to
go for the grandma.
Penguins are from the South Pole, Bill.
Do not get this guy. All right? Do not get him. He basically fires rocket launchers indoors. He's a complete nutcase. Now, granted, you are an evil genius, so it was is helpful. But what I'm saying is don't get him. He will blow your shit up worse than these soldiers will. So I might have to send... A new henchman is arriving. Great, you can go in and do your mothering thing on these guys. See, at least he's held these guys up as they're trying to break the door down. So, what's going on over here? Oh, burglars. Where is she? Exceptional patriot burglar. Yeah, well, can't be that exceptional if you can't dodge bullets and you won't be able to soon, dear. So, let's see. Good, these are good. Okay. Have we got him? I think we're very close. It's like a 5-minute operation, I think. So if we get him, then we're in a position to progress. And this would have been an extremely hard fought battle. So let's just see what my notoriety is. See, bad 83, so it's either 80 or 75 to get Nigel Ewing to turn up on the... on the world map. I got that one as well, which is good news, so we can start plotting.
Warning, high security door breached.
There we go. High security door breached. Congratulations, have a cookie. Now Now the question is, where is Jubai? Here he is.
I use a many strange bars.
Come on, Grandma, you can go in the dirt as well.
You have to be cruel to be cruel.
I love the Grandma, she's awesome. Come on, Jubai, come on, Jubai, kick their asses. God, more of the stupid bent. Good lad, Jubai, quick, get him, get him.
I live to sever.
Now, where is the Grandma? No, Grandma, I want you to take these guys out.
Discipline must be maintained.
Oh.
Shalom, this is the Pan-Arabic Wireless Service. The former CIA agent, Nigel Ewing, has long been suspected of smuggling guns into the Middle East with the intention of inciting...
Mission success! Yeah,
a
bitches.
The cache of Ewing's
there we go. So, the Grandma should arrive shortly. Hello, Grandma. So she can do special attacks like electroshock therapy and motherly love, which I think is quite cool. Basically makes him grow all lovey-dovey and like, oh, and she can... So she's a good combo. Go on, go up, give him a hug. But no, she's got a ball and chain.
Oh
no, she's taking shock because her friend has snuffed it. Come on. Swing that Morning Star girl. Matron, isn't it past your bedtime? There we go. Well done, old girl. Well done, old girl. I'm impressed. So, all we got to do now, basically, is get all those bodies out of the way, including that boy there. Loads of tourists. This boy here who's moving into his location. So Bob Barking from the East End, he's not going to go down with the fight. Fighters loyal with Lanny on the shores. Oh, for God's sake. So basically, he's going to be sending loads of troops down, and we're going to probably get pwned. And not in a good way. So if we move that down to about 20. Oh, there we go. Let's move to 30. There we go. So that's that guy there. And let's see, we got 18 out of 30 minions, so let's get 30 minions in total, because then we can get them training, get them valeted up, and technicianed up, and soldiered up, or guarded up, I should say. So. Yep, there's Bob Barker's lads, enemy minions, mark them all for assassination. All will be assassinated when their time comes. Now, what I might not do is I might not end the episode until these guys have been beaten off, as in killed, before you think say anything else, and we'll go from there. So let's see. Everything's quiet. So let's see if Jubai can get in there. Can he? How's his health? His health is looking good, but he doesn't have a wind walk yet. So we might wait for him to get a wind walk, jump in amongst these lot and chop them all into chunks, which would obviously be rather amusing. So not so tough now, are you, Bob Barker? Although that sounds like the guy from Long Good Friday. But I guess we'll find out. Come on. Waiting for the wind walk. That basically means he can gather people to him. There we go. Get in there, chop them all up. They're only enemy minions, so they probably won't last that long. No, don't, oh, for God's sake. He's a good lad, but he's not that smart in that respect. Okay, let's send the other girl in.
Time for the medicine. Discipline must be maintained.
Blimey, they made a load of Grandma really quickly. Bloody hell. No, don't. Oh, no, I think there's more than just one there, so. Flipping Chinese guys. Where are my men? Why do I have no guards there to do anything about it? It's a bit frustrating, to say the least. See, they're going to walk around, they're going to flipping start shooting everything and blowing up everything. And minions are getting pwned. Minions are pwned. You know what? I think we're going to call this chapter an end. And we will bring you the outcome of these little buggers in chapter 5. So I hope you enjoyed this extra long Evil Genius, How to Be Evil. See you in the next chapter, guys. I hope you enjoyed yourself. See you again soon.